Wisdom is the principal thing. Therefore, get wisdom, and with all thy getting, get understanding. Proverbs 4:7. The individuals that constitute the body of mankind are most certainly going to perish if they continue down the dead-end road they are now on. The handwriting is blazoned upon the proverbial wall for all to see. Human beings cannot continue to violate the universal laws of being, whether willfully or ignorantly, that govern the operation of the universe, and hope to survive. If mankind is to survive, there must be those stout-hearted individuals who not only understand what is actually required to ensure mankind's survival, but are willing to wholeheartedly commit themselves to putting into practice what they have come to understand. Clearly, the survival of mankind is not something that can be achieved by the capricious scheming of the short-sighted human intellect. It was and is man's unruly intellect that set in motion man's descent into the darkened state of consciousness which now enshrouds the entire planet. The epic inner journey, The Choice is Yours, provides a basic introduction into the dynamics of how life works. Make no mistake, life works a certain way. There are definite laws and principles that govern every aspect of life. Without a basic understanding of how life works, human beings have no way to understand the true purpose for their existence on Earth, where and how they fit in. Tragically, most human beings remain completely in the dark when it comes to understanding how life actually works and where and how they fit in. Without a basic understanding of how life works, human beings have no way to begin the extraordinary inner process of reharmonizing with the universal laws and principles that strictly govern the operation of the entire universal system. In the process of reharmonizing with life, human beings must first acquire a basic understanding of how life actually works, followed by the deliberate, conscious choice to be true to their new understanding. The epic inner journey, The Choice is Yours, was written to assist earnest pilgrims on their epic inner journey of self-discovery as an individualized part of the universal system. Without a basic understanding of how life works, the earnest pilgrim will needlessly remain lost in an inner labyrinth filled with bewilderment and frustration, from which there is no possibility of escape. In the absence of true understanding, we have the classic situation of the blind leading the blind, and everyone falls into the ditch. By the look of things, that ditch is not too far off for the body of mankind. The epic inner journey, The Choice is Yours, provides compelling answers to age-old unanswered questions that have perplexed human beings for countless generations. The one question that remains to be answered, however, is whether the solution provided by these compelling answers will be accepted and acted upon by the readers of this book. For the reader's sake and the sake of mankind, let us hope that a few courageous individuals will step forward and choose to take up this noble challenge. For those courageous individuals, the epic inner journey has begun. As always, the choice is yours. Paradoxically, it is in the complete dissolution of who you presently think and feel you are that permits the revelation in consciousness of who you truly are to be known and experienced. Walt Whitman. You have not known what you are. You have slumbered upon yourself all your life. Whoever you are, claim your own. The restoration of human consciousness is a recovery process. The epic inner journey is a journey of recovery. It is the step-by-step process of returning to and re-experiencing a resplendent state of consciousness that human beings lost conscious awareness and experience of countless generations ago. In order for human beings to recover that lost state of consciousness, they must willingly commit themselves to a rigorous recovery process. What makes the process so rigorous is the fact that human beings are highly addicted and are totally unaware, for the most part, that they are addicted. Starting at a young age, they learn to accept human nature beliefs and behavior patterns as perfectly normal. Their parents were similarly addicted, and so unwittingly passed the deadly addiction to their unsuspecting and innocent children. What is humanity's drug of choice? What is the drug that human beings worldwide are so helplessly addicted to that it has brought the body of mankind to the brink of self-annihilation? Simply stated, human beings are addicted to having their own way. They foolishly attempt to substitute their ways for life's way. In the process, human beings have separated themselves from the conscious experience of being part of life's grand design. There is only one way, and that is life's way. Make no mistake, life's way will not be pushed aside or take second seat in order to satisfy the arbitrary and irrational ways of self-serving, self-centered human beings. By willfully choosing to impose and substitute their ways in place of life's way, human beings have collectively backed themselves into a corner from which there is no escape as long as they continue to deny the fact of their present addiction. The first step in recovery is predicated upon the addict honestly acknowledging the fact of their addiction. It is only after the addict has honestly faced the fact of their own inner condition that the recovery process can proceed. For those courageous individuals who are willing to acknowledge the fact of their own addiction to having their own way, their epic inner journey has just begun. Alexander Pope. A man should never be ashamed to own that he has been in the wrong, which is but saying, in other words, that he is wiser today than he was yesterday. Recovery is the act of finding something you lost. When a person becomes aware that they have lost something of great value, they will relentlessly search until they find what has been lost. When an addict recovers, they emphatically proclaim, "I got my life back." The life they got back is something that in fact was never lost. It was always with them, but was temporarily obscured behind a time-worn and tattered veil woven out of who they mistakenly thought they were. The life they got back is something that in fact was never lost. It was always with them, but was temporarily obscured behind a time-worn and tattered veil woven out of who they mistakenly thought they were. The addict found what was seemingly lost by finally choosing to deliberately relinquish the destructive, self-serving patterns of behavior and belief that had held them captive and formed the ramshackle infrastructure of their addicted disposition. The life they seemingly lost was found waiting outside the squalid prison cell they had unwittingly fashioned for themselves. Life condemns no one to a life filled with pain and suffering. However, human beings will needlessly continue to condemn themselves to a life filled with pain and suffering as long as they choose to disregard and violate the immutable laws of life. Shankara. Who is more deluded than he who is careless of his own welfare? The master key that opens the lock on your prison cell door is your ability to choose. You have only two choices. One, you can choose to deliberately maintain and remain subject to limiting and discordant and destructive patterns of behavior and belief that now circumscribe and govern the quality and nature of your present life. Or two, you can willingly choose to participate in life's ongoing creative processes by letting your present state of consciousness be clarified and restored, and by so doing, provide an open channel through which the revelation of life's glorious living design can once more be known on earth because you are present. Vernon Howard, you have the choice to drop the false assumption that you presently have choice. There is no difference between your choice and that of God, truth, nature, call it what you like. You and life are one. Which is peace. Henry Amiel, our liberty, wisely understood, is but a voluntary obedience to the universal laws of being. For as long as the breath of life, the life-sustaining universal spirit, is animating our bodies, the opportunity exists for us to awaken and remember the true purpose for our presence on earth. In order to take advantage of the ever-present opportunity to awaken, to remember who and what we are, we must be willing to adhere to three basic rules listed below. Failure to follow these rules will guarantee that we remain confined within the claustrophobic prison cells we have unwittingly fashioned for ourselves. In order to free oneself from one's inner prison cell, one must be willing to fully commit oneself to strictly following these three basic rules. When the three basic rules are adhered to, we are not only freeing ourselves, but more importantly, we are contributing to the worldwide restoration of human consciousness. The consciousness of the body of mankind clearly requires restoration. That essential restoration can only be realized when there are individuals who let the restoration of consciousness be a reality within themselves. No longer is the restoration of one's consciousness undertaken for self-centered, ego-driven purposes. We no longer permit long-standing, humanly contrived, petty purposes to influence our behavior. The greater purpose for which we are called is to take part in the restoration of the consciousness of mankind. The three basic rules provide the only way the greater purpose can be achieved, and the prison cell doors that have imprisoned mankind finally be unlocked. There is not just one door, there is in fact a plethora of doors that keeps one confined within one's private prison cell. In Chapter 3, Exposing the Imposter Self, there is a list of doors that must be deliberately cast aside, let go of, before we can ever hope to be truly free as individuals or as a collective. The invisible doors that are keeping you imprisoned are your individual imposter self-character traits, nothing else. Only you can take the necessary step to set yourself free. Your heartfelt acknowledgement that you have unwittingly been existing in a multi-doored prison cell is your first step towards freeing yourself from all the pernicious states of consciousness that have kept you imprisoned. Not until you are willing to let go of what is actually causing all your mental and emotional pain and suffering will it stop. Can you think of any rational reason for continuing to hold on to what has been hurting you your entire life? It is never too late to let go. Listed below are the three basic rules which, when applied to your daily life, will open the door to the totally new life you have always suspected was possible. You were just never instructed how the prison cell doors could finally be opened. Make the choice to consciously follow the three basic rules, and the doors will surely open. Arthur Schopenhauer. You need not fancy it is impossible to regulate your life in accordance with abstract ideas and maxims. The first thing to do is to understand the rule. The second thing is to learn the practice of it. The theory may be understood at once by the effort of reason, and yet the practice of it acquired only in the course of time.